We're live.
Okay. All right. We are live. Hey, everybody. Hello, hello. Welcome. Monday night. Can you believe it's the last Monday night of February? I mean, it's we blink and the month is gone. And so tonight is going to be a little celebration, but a lot of education. And we're going to go longer than 30 minutes. I apologize, but there's so many great things that I want to share with you tonight. First of all, we're ending up the month, short month, but guys, we're coming in at about 400 new AROs and 38 partners have three or more orders. So yay. We are back in the saddle and we're back in the swing of things. So congratulations, each and every one of you. And I'm impressed and just know that I appreciate you all. So we're going to start tonight with one of our partners that is busting out the leaderboard here for the month of February. And I just wanted to celebrate Henry Hageman tonight. You know, Henry Hageman is the national marketing director, has been with the company for 30 years. He's just a precious friend. We have drank many bottles of wine in many different locations, Jen and Henry and myself. But when a national marketing director puts on seven new AROs in a short month, and then Jen put on, I saw three new AROs, I think it's time to celebrate the Hageman. So I thought we would ask Henry to come to the call and congratulate you. And Henry, what is going on?
Well, thanks, Terry. It is, it's incredible. It is 30 years this August, I think, that I will have been with the company. And, you know, we went to Florida about 4 years ago and COVID hit and I spent a lot of time with Jen's mom and she had a long run with cancer and we sort of just got off the train. We had a time getting ourselves back on the train. It's a fascinating process, but nonetheless, I'm still here. Jen's still here. And the passion burns from below. And we are really excited about Juice Plus again. Not that we ever stopped taking it, not that we ever stopped talking about it, but the level of passion has gone up rather a good bit, shall we say. And it is amazing when your intent is to reach people. And you start with a purpose at the beginning of the month saying, okay, this is what I want to do. I want to reach 10 people this month. I'm pretty close. You know, Terry said seven, but I got another one after we spoke today and I've got two more, I think, that are going to hit tomorrow. So it's been a fascinating process and it's just finding it ourselves has just been time with us. Time getting ourselves pulled together again, getting some of the stinking thinking out of the head and working with a coach that we really believe in and just making a purpose and really realizing that of all the things that are out there in the world for us, and we let a lot of things go over the last 4 or 5 years. And when we started really reevaluating what was really important, Juice Plus, oddly enough, 30 years, came right back up to the forefront and being out there and being able to just spend some time and share some love with people. We've got a guy here today. I'll be brief. One guy who started on the quad and then fell in love with the shakes earlier this month. He's a lineman. He works really brutal hours up in high tension, 340,000 volt wires. And they come home and they do a good bit of drinking at night. And he said he was tired all the time. And I said, this is just something you've got to do, Wynn. And he started it like a week and a half ago. And he came back today, been in Maine. His color was, I mean, it was unbelievable to see the change in his face. He was alert. He was excited. He was happy. He was, you know, just, he was back in life. And being able to share that with people is really important. And we've always believed it, but by gum, we pulled ourselves out of a ditch and we're here today.
You know, Henry, I was thinking about you're pulling yourself out of the ditch. I think so many of the people tonight on the call have not been with the company for, all right, there's Amy Hawkins. Look at everybody going out. It's amazing. Not been with the company for 30 years, but been with the company for 10 years or 5 years or 3 years. And I think we're all embracing the same thing. I think we're all pulling ourselves out of the same ditch. And you're embracing, what I love is that you're embracing the beginning of each month with a strong intentionality. Mm-hmm. You know, you said, I am going to put 10 people on the product this month, end of story. And so call it a goal, call it an intention, whatever you want to call it. But boy, if you don't have that intention, you'll land somewhere, but who knows where. So it's that mindset of working from that strong intention that's paying off. And so now we're up to 8 AROs, Henry. Congratulations.
We are.
And I think we can do business all day tomorrow, right?
I think we can. I think we can.
So we're rooting for you, Henry. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Terry.
Thank you. Appreciate you. All right. Hey, guys. Okay. All right. We're going to show you a video clip from National Marketing Director Amanda Wright. And she was, I don't know if I could say show of hands, how many of you plugged into Level Up? I got to tell you, I don't think a lot of us did on Team Up. And I kind of hold myself kind of responsible for that because I didn't promote it a whole lot. But everybody that did watch it, I've got to tell you, I kept hearing the same thing over again. Oh my gosh, Level Up. I heard it from Kathy. I heard it from Abby. I heard it from somebody else. There's this woman who did this training on social media. So I paid Lauren LaHave for the extended trainings and she just published them. She just put them online just a couple days ago. So I've been waiting for the rebroadcast of all these programs. And so Amanda Wright made National Marketing Director living in Uganda. Okay. And what she credits are these social media power hours. Now, a lot of us have participated in power hours, right? I mean, I've done hundreds, but I'm going to tell you, this is a power hour with grit and purpose. And I tell you, this girl is onto something. So take a look, take a listen. It's 14 minutes, and then we will regroup, paper and pad, get ready to take some notes, but just know that this training will always be available now on Team Up. Okay, go ahead, Kathy.
Next, amazing woman, an amazing mama. She's a yoga guru, I would say. She started her career in physical therapy, and she graduated from college with a master's in physical therapy as well. But she, are you ready? How many of you have some excuses of why you don't build your business? Come on, put your hand up. Who's got some excuses of why they're not building their business? This woman built her business. Ready? Ready? Are you ready to know what she did? She built her business to NMD from Uganda. So when you say you can't do events and you can't do all these things, she built it in a country weren't even well. She was up in the morning, late at night. Can you please, she now lives in Denver with her husband, John, and their two boys. Can you please give it up for Amanda Wright, who's gonna talk about massive freaking action.
Time, so sit down. And I also did not get the black pants memo. I saw that in the chat, so but I'm loving all the black pants. So I have about 10 minutes, guys, to share with you something that has changed our business. And I wanted to start out with why maybe you should take a listen. So as Lauren said, I'm a national marketing director. I moved back from Uganda 4 years ago, and really we had reached a time in our team where we were feeling kind of blah. And I'll show you my slides. Where are my slides? Anyway, you'll see them in a minute. But I have my five C's on why you should buy into me today for the next 10 minutes, because we're going to be talking about social media power hour. Who has done a power hour before? Awesome! Yes. Who has been part of my power hour before? Yes! Awesome. So these are the reasons I think you should tune in for the next 10 minutes. One is clarity. Who wants more clarity in their business? When you get online, what you're going to do, who you're going to reach out to, I know that we all could use more of that. Connection, being able to be around more people. We talked about that peer group, feeling connected. Number three is certainty, knowing, again, what you're doing when you get online, more certain about your daily method of operation. Number four is C is customers. Oh my goodness, when you're part of a power hour, your customer count, I can't tell you how many teammates have 10 or more customers because they've been part of our power hour every day. And then number five, and sorry, I'm a mom of teens, so I only had a dollar in my pocket, but you get cash. Your money is gonna go up in your paycheck because you're part of a power hour. So what is a power hour? Has anyone found my slides? No. Oh, boy. Okay, so I'm going to try to do this without my slides. We're going to go with it. So we started our power hour about 2 years ago during the pandemic because we were feeling pretty blah. And I had this great picture of somebody feeling pretty blah. But we would look at our social media, we'd go online, and it was like, what are we doing? Why are we doing this? We felt pretty disconnected. So we wanted to feel more like, and picture a picture of people in a coffee shop. We wanted more of that coffee shop vibe. And you guys know what I mean. You go in a coffee shop, you got the barista, you got the big table, everyone's working, you got the vibe, you maybe ask some questions. We wanted more of that. And I had heard about this idea of the power hour, and I thought, maybe let's give this a try. I think this might be our ticket to feel more connected. So we hopped online. Our team decided, oh, there we go. See, there's our, yes! We're rolling with it. All right. So this is what we wanted. We wanted this vibe. So we had the idea that to start a power hour. And so I committed, leaders go first, right? I committed for my team to do Monday through Thursday from 11 to 11:45. We've been doing this 2 years solid now. And we, as I said, the five C's of what we gotten out of it. So what I want to tell you is exactly in the next 6 minutes how to run your own power hour. You do not have to be an NMD. You do not have to be a, quote, leader in the team. You guys are all your own leaders. So I want you to walk away knowing how to do this. My tips for success is be consistent. Pick a time that you're going to run your power hour and do it when you say you're going to do it, right? So for me, that was Monday through Thursday. Friday, I have a yoga class I really like to go to. I wasn't going to commit to Friday. So Monday through Thursday are my times, and I already told you the time. So be consistent. Maybe you pick the next 4 months to be consistent, and then you reassess. Okay, so I don't care what time you choose, just choose a time and be there. Find a buddy. Cynthia's one of my buddies. Stephanie's one of my buddies. If I can't be there for some reason, I call on them. Hey, can you pinch hit for me? So have a backup. Be accountable, right? We just say this a lot. Do what you say what you do. If you're gonna show up, show up. Have fun. Again, if you want people to show up on your power hour, you gotta have a little fun. Make it a space that people wanna be part of. And then we always like to play music and have different playlists. Sometimes we use YouTube, so always make sure to have fun. So our first, it's on Zoom. We give our login, and the first 5 or 10 minutes is really just to check in. Your job is to create an environment, a space that people feel welcome, right? And so we start with mindset. We want a quick update from everyone. What's your top win for the weekend? What did you do? What did you follow? Who'd you follow up with yesterday? Maybe you share your story. If you're first time on my power hour, you're sharing your story. No, and I want to create that right away. We'd love to hear why you started Juice Plus. Tell me what have you noticed? And then I do a little coaching perhaps, or perhaps not. So asking them to share their story. we share our posting ideas for the day. Hey, it's Wellness Wednesday. Here's a great tip. Or Testimony Tuesday. Or there's that Tower Garden event tonight. Did you post about that yet? So we're sharing right away what we're posting. And then sometimes we ask a question. I like on my team to ask, you know, just a fun question. If someone asks you what you do, what do you say? And we go around and share. Or who knows what POB is, right? And then we go around and share. 5 to 10 minutes most. Warm up. So we're warming up for 5 to 10 minutes. Social media, the platforms they want you to be on and they want you to stay on, right? So if you're going to choose Instagram or Facebook, whatever platform, go into that platform and warm up. This is your chance to be a go-giver. This is not your chance to log on and say, oh my gosh, I got to reach out and share Juice Plus with everyone in the first 5 minutes. This is you just, happy birthday. How are the kids? How is your weekend? You know, we do a lot of just liking and loving and connecting. This is not, there's nothing to do with Juice Plus here. It's really just connecting. You're going to message any new friends or followers. Hey, it's so great to be connected. I see we're both in that yoga Facebook group page. Where do you practice? We say hi to people who are online. We go in Messenger and see who's online. So really quick warm up. Make new friends. And so our job in our business, we are professional networkers, right? Our job is literally to make new friends all the time. And so if we do this in real life and we do this online. When you're online, and this is something we do every day in the Power Hour, we want to try to meet new people. And so we are joining Facebook groups, we're in Facebook groups, introducing ourselves, we're meeting new friends that way, we're going on Instagram. And I wish I could lead you through guys through all this, but you're welcome to hop on my Power Hour at any time and I'll lead you through it there. Or, you know, I can always answer any questions. We go into Instagram hashtags, friends of friends. Maybe it's the mom you met at the play date last Thursday, and you find her on Facebook and send her a message and tell her about, you know, the diaper bag that you liked or whatever. So, Lex 5 to 10 minutes is digging in. We want to go one level deeper in social media. We want to see who's watching us, who's looking at us, who's watching our stories that maybe we don't know. And so we go in and we go a level deeper. We're seeing who's answering our polls, who have we forgotten about, who maybe has commented on something, you know, a couple of days ago that we forgot to answer, right? So we're digging in and finding the next level of people and friends to connect with. And this is the piece I think this is so critical of our Power Hour, because this is something a new person just isn't going to know how to do. If you're new on social media, you're not used to using social media as a networking opportunity, you may miss out on this. So I think this is a really critical piece. All right, this is the meat and potatoes of our Power Hour, is inviting. So as I said in the beginning, we do quick announcements, we let people know what's going on for the day or the week. So if tonight, let's say there's a talk on the Tower Garden, we are going to potentially share some wording on, okay, what do you actually say to someone if you're going to invite them to this Tower Garden talk? We go over, how do you find the prospects that you've already been talking about on about the Tower Garden? And we have a few good tips on that. And then we go in and we invite. So we put on our music, we send the invitations, and we're inviting to in-person events, online events, business opportunity, sending out samples, inviting people for a coffee catch-up or just a virtual catch-up. What I love about this, too, is we go out and we do our invitations, and then we come back and I say, share what you wrote. Let's hear it. You know, let's hear what you said. And we all share different ideas. And I always say, I want it to sound like you. Here's an idea. Here's a way you maybe could approach or send the invite, but I want it to sound like you. And everyone shares what they sent. And then, of course, we want to follow up. And we do this, if it's a Thursday, we're going to go back to Monday and Tuesday of our Power Hour and say, who'd you reach out to? Who do you need to follow up? This is really about being a professional, right? And a new person on the team needs to know how to follow up. If they just invite and they don't follow up, they're probably not getting the results that they want. So be a professional follow-up. Show that you care. Relate back to your why or interest. Give them next steps. Be confident and track conversations. And this is something that we teach on the Power Hour too, is how are you tracking your conversations? I want to know. And then we end with gratitude. I think this is so fun. We always end with a minute or two of just, hey, send somebody a note about something and say thank you. Could be a customer that, you know, wrote you back. It could be your husband that walked the dog so you could take a call. It could be your kid that took their Juice Plus that morning and they've been struggling to take it and they finally took their Juice Plus. So sideline buddy, maybe that's helped you out. Send a note of gratitude. So, you know, I think hopefully, does everyone, give me a hands up or a one if this sounds like something that you are interested in doing with your team, finding a buddy, yes. So, you know, I really just challenge you before you leave today to make a plan with somebody. Give it a try. And by a try, I don't mean let's try it for 1 week. Just like Juice Plus, it may take a while to get some momentum on this. But if you commit to doing this yourself, and heck, I am online a lot of times and it's just me, and that's okay. I put on my Zoom, I get my stuff out, and I'm working. I'm committed to my own business first. So if you are the one that's in charge and you're the only one working, that's okay. And then maybe you text a few people and say, hey, where are you today? Let's hop online together. But it's okay if you're the only one. So please, I welcome you to join our Power Hour next week. I'm opening it up to anyone and everyone. Let me know and I can give you our Zoom number. Obviously, you can follow me on Instagram or Facebook and send me a message that way. But I really hope for all of us to level up this year, level up our social media, level up our connections and our commitment to our business. So thank you guys.
All right. Okay, guys, when I saw this training, and it was no coincidence that I'm in, Amy Hopkins says, and I saw this thing on Instagram. It was Confucius who said, I hear and I forget. I see and I remember. I do and I understand. Aha. So here's the skinny on this, guys. There are some of you out there that are really proficient on social media, but your teams are not. Your teams, they don't know what to post. They don't know what to say. They don't. And I would be one of those people. You know, I did a post last night on the Omegas. It only took me 3 days to put it together. It's a whole lot of work. It's very successful. I called it True Confessions. I was going to call it True Confessions of a Very Vain Woman about why I really love the Omegas, but it took me forever. So this is what I'm going to encourage you to do. I am going to reach out to Amanda and I'm going to ask her if I can sit in on a couple of her power hours. I would encourage you to do that too, especially if you have a team. And then if you are a leader and you are good and you would consider doing this on a regular basis, I would love to partner with you, those of you that want to step up and do this. Because she said at the end of the day, you know, she puts her own business first. So it's a win-win no matter what. But this is a power hour with grit and outline. It's a little bit of what Henry talked about. This is intentional power hour. And I think it could be a win for all of us. So yes, Kim. So love to visit with you, especially those of you that already do a good job with social media. And let's see if we can't maybe lock arms together, maybe a couple sideline team leaders that want to get together, do it once or twice a week. I think she does it 4 days a week. That might be a bit of a task to start out with, but we need to start somewhere. So anybody, if you have any comments that you want to throw out based on what you heard, just, you know, unmute yourselves and let's hear what you have to say.
Carrie, I'll share. I started doing this with my team a couple weeks ago. So we're doing it once a week and it's been amazing and intentional time just to know that you can sit down and you know, work on your business. And so I'm just going to encourage you, like, we didn't start with 4 days a week. We're just starting with 1 day a week right now. So if that's what you can commit to, then commit to 1 day a week and 45 minutes to an hour of, you know, really focusing on your business is going to be powerful.
Yeah. Abby, I saw, you know, that you did it with your team. And I love, you know, how Amanda broke it down, you know, first 10 minutes, next 10 minutes, next 10 minutes, you know, inviting is the meat of this. And so few of us know how to do that effectively. So I just need to, you guys need to know that this training right here, because eventually Lauren will take down these recordings, but it will always be available right here on Team Up so that we can, you know, refer back to it. Because I think this is such valuable, you know, we know that so much business is done on social media. And, you know, what if your teams could be as effective as you are with social media? Wouldn't that be something? Just imagine what that could be. Anybody else have any comments? All right. So talk about inviting. Last Thursday night, Abby, myself, and Steph Fletch did an event on Zoom, and we called it Hope, Healing, and I forgot what we called it, but it was about hope, health, and healing. And it was the three of us telling our stories, and it was recorded. And what my intention is to do with this recording, and I heard so many people say it was just phenomenal. Michelle Halverson, I started to plan this because Michelle Halverson here in Oregon wanted to do some events in her home. And I came up with the idea, well, what if, you know, the three of us, you know, generationally, three different generations sharing our stories. And so Abby shared her story about surviving and thriving through anxiety and depression. Steph Fletcher shared her story. I'm going to cry. About surviving and thriving through cancer. And I shared my story about surviving and thriving through some very challenging autoimmune conditions. So what I want to do with this is that because events grow our business, that next week, our Monday night call, we're going to broadcast this YouTube presentation. And we will recreate the flyers. We will have, you know, the new date on there. We'll have a flyer without the Zoom information. That is something you share after someone says, yes, I would like to participate. Do not post the flyer with the Zoom information on your social media page. You may promote the event without the Zoom information. But so next Monday night is going to be an event. An event that you can promote on social media, one-on-one conversations. Henry, I know that you and Jen, if you want to unmute yourself, each had five people that were interested in hearing this call. Have any of them responded to our stories?
Yes, two of my people have and loved it. It was just too late for them. One was sick and just needed to crash before 10 o'clock rolled around back here. But no, it was fantastic presentation. Both heard very different things. You know, three people speaking, there was a lot of different thoughts. And so it's just fascinating who hears what.
Yeah. And so what the idea here is, Henry, is that you promoted an event. And of course, it was, 7 o'clock Pacific time. I did it that because so much of our Pacific Coast business is ignored because we always do everything to complement Central and Eastern time. So I thought it was time to do something for Pacific. But the fact is it's recorded. It is amazing. The feedback, I know that Michelle Halverson has at least four people now coming to product because of that call. Yeah. So look at Abby. Yeah. So congratulations. So we're going to make that available. It's going to be next Monday night. All right. One more thing. I know some of you may want to jump off, but did you know that you actually have partner affiliates who do not know how to set up a cart? Now, I'm going to tell you right now, some of you like Abby, you have a younger team. who grew up just kind of like coming out of utero knowing how to do this. And I thought for the longest time that maybe it was like the 50, 60 year old crowd that didn't know how to set up a cart. But I had a team leader, a sales coordinator, senior sales coordinator in her early 40s who brought on a new partner. And she said, "Hey, Terry, I don't know how to coach her on how to set up a cart because I don't know how to do it." Oh, look at John L. Yes, ma'am. Okay. So I asked Kathy, our own Vanna White, Kathy Schlun, because she's a great teacher and educator, if she would record on YouTube how to set up a cart. And it is a 10-minute presentation, and she takes you through every angle of it. And we're going to broadcast it right here and know that it's recorded. But I think it's going to be an incredible tool. Stacey Whitmer is already very interested in viewing it so that she can post it on boards. Congratulations, Kathy, you're about to become a celebrity. She's going to view it because she wants to post it on boards so that everybody can have access to this. Because guys, I'm going to tell you, if 40-year-olds don't know how to set up a cart, it's an issue, because I'm guarantee you it's one of the reasons that is holding partners back from driving business. Because people today want a cart. So it's business today. All right. So Kathy, if you want to run with this, guys, and after that, we'll say goodnight, but I want you to see what's available to you. Carts speak to the hearts. Yes. And so here we're going to have a tool that we can share with our partners so that they'll know how to do it effectively. Go ahead, Kathy.
I've been asked to do a quick tutorial on creating a cart, creating it for a potential customer, how to send it to them. And what I thought I'd add to it is let you see what it looks like on the other end when you send it to the customer, and then how they then can click on this link that they can have the option of checking out as a guest or actually helping them to be able to create their own customer portal at that time. They have that option, which I would strongly suggest you encourage them to do. And then how they can go in and modify the cart and put in their own credit card information so that they have their own account. So those are the steps of what we're going to go through right now. And I'm going to start by sharing my screen. And when I do this, what I'm going to show you is that what we're going to do is go to myjuiceplus.com. And here you'll notice, and when you look here in the URL box, that there's no name. Whose account are we going to? Well, that's what we're going to do. I'm going to show you quickly. So I'm going to move myself out of the way, and we'll sign in and sign in as a partner. And I'm going to sign in as Terry here, and we're going to put in all of her information, and we're going to her myjuiceplus.com. So as you see here, it says, "Hi, Terry," and this is her dashboard. Okay, so we know that we're into Terry's. What we're going to do is we're going to shop here. So let's shop. We're going to set up this cart for the customer, and we're going to order Juice Plus. We're not going to go with Healthy Starts. We're not going to do Tower Gardens right now. We're just going to do a basic Juice Plus order. So where do we start? We're not starting with the product when we are sending a cart to someone. We're going to start with the information. And let's not put somebody who's already in. Are you ordering for yourself? No. So we're going to go down here and we're going to do Mary Lou Smith. Okay. Phone number is important, so we can take care of that. Let's make up 1-987-6543. And now the next that is absolutely required and very important is the email address. This is required for a couple of reasons. Obviously, we're going to send them an email, but with all this information. But as it goes forward, it may end up being that we are actually using the email address to identify people, not necessarily phone numbers. It's also important to have that good daytime telephone number. So when you're calling and you're doing your customer care, or if for some reason the company needs to get a hold of them, you've got a good phone number to get for the majority of the day to be able to talk with them. So what I'm going to do is I am actually going to put in my own email address, because what's important here is that we are going to share with them, and I want to show you what's on the other end. So here we go. We've got my email address in there. And so we're just going to make up any old product or address. But let's find 567. Let's do Main Street in Minnesota. Okay, it doesn't matter that I've got this in there, but here is what we have for their email, their basic address. I am their partner. You could do this if you're setting it up for a different partner, but let's just go with the basics here. Next, well, what are we going to order? I'm going to order a couple of things so that you can see how we can change this once it gets to the customer. So we're going to order the fruit and vegetables. We're going to have some capsules. And what we're going to do is throw in, let's do a recurring order of some bars. All right. So we have all of these three items in their cart, and we're going to go all the way down to the bottom. It says review order. Here we go. All right, let's take a look at Mary Lou Smith's order. She's got an Omega blend, she's got the bars, and she has the capsules. And here we have what's included. This is her monthly payment. This is what's going to be her taxes. And we could check out for her if we had her credit card information, but we don't. So what we're going to do is we're going to share the cart, and we'll click on share cart. When you do that, you see that Mary Lou's cart is ready for sharing. So how are we going to share this cart? We can send it via email, which we're going to do, but let's say you're doing this from your phone and you just want to copy and get a copy of the link. And so you either have that in your phone, or it's already saved here. And you could go to text messages and send it to them from this point. But what we're going to do here is we're going to send it via email. Okay, so the email address shows up here. What we're going to do is click on that. Now, you had copied the link, so you could go into your own email and create that and send it from there because you've already got the link. But in this case, we're just going to send it right from here. So what's the subject? New Juice Plus product order is waiting for you. You could do whatever you want to put as the subject line. And so just to make things easier, I'm just going to copy that and say, hey, Mary Lou, here is your New Juice Plus product order. You asked me to set up for you. And then you can give her instructions. Just click on the link below. And create your account. Fill in your credit card information and your order will be on its way. And don't forget, we're sending this. This is Terry's customer. So I'm just going to go down here and say, have a great day. Call me if you need anything. Terry. Okay, and we're gonna send it away. So there, the message was sent. All right, I'm going to do something now. Did I make sure that you understand that I am doing here, because we have Terry already logged in. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to log out here. This is just completely for the purpose of this demonstration. So now I'm going to go to my email and let's see what's coming. Your new Just Plus order is waiting for you. So it says, hey, Mary Lou, here's your new Just product, your new Juice Plus product order you asked me to set up for you. So let's see what happens when I click on this link. Oh, Terry has sent you a card. Please enter your email address is what it's going to look like for them on the other end. And we can go to cart now. Here it is, right here. Now, I want to, you know what? I'm looking at this and you know what? I guess I really don't want the bars. So I'm going to click this little X over here and boom, it's ready to go. I'm ready to buy the Omega and the capsules. So I'm going to proceed to checkout. Here is the cool part for us to really encourage these new customers to get their own little portal. They can either log in if they are already a customer, or they can create an account. And I'm going to click on that right now to show you what it can look like. Join Juice Plus, join Juice Plus. Okay, so you want to create an account. I'm not going to do that right now, actually, because that's not going to work for me because I've already got my own and everything else and that email address. So I'm just going to go back and I'm going to check out as guest. So they could do that too, but here we go. So this is what it's going to look like. Here it is. I've got the omegas. We got the fruit and vegetable blend. I'm double checking. I've got my name is right. My phone number is right. Obviously, my email address is right. And my address is exactly on. Here's my partner, the shipping and everything else is the same. So I'm good to go. I'm going to continue to payment. And I'm going to put the information in. Got it? Does that make sense? Is that easy enough for you? It's really very simple way to handle this, especially because you now have them that they can create their own account. They can manage their own things as time goes on if they choose.
All right. Does anybody have any questions, clarifying points?
I do.
Yeah. Go ahead. Hi, Janelle. Go ahead.
Hello. Okay. So you can delete a product, or the customer can get that shared cart. They can delete a product, but I didn't see where they could add more products.
They can't. They can only do that when they can do that, but it's going to take them away from that page and it doesn't build in. I tried playing with it to do that. Okay. If they want to add something else, they can. Complete this order and then order more.
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Because one thing I didn't point out is that you can see that you're on Terry's website up in the upper left-hand corner. That's what I was pointing out at first. When we first went in there, we just went to the general, but every time they clicked on that, when they clicked on that link, it took her to Terry's Juice Plus website. So if she, even if she were signing in as guest, and then she wanted to add some, create another order, she was still on Terry's website.
Thank you, Kathy. Anybody else have any comments or questions? Or
one quick thing, you only need their email and their phone number. You do not have to put in their address, just their email and their phone number, and they can fill that in when you send the card.
Yes. Okay. That's very, yeah, it's very helpful. One more.
Really helpful to have their name in there though.
Well, yeah, name, email, and phone number, sorry.
Okay.
You're good.
All right. So guys, if any of you want this recording, we're gonna play it again in the future. You know, maybe run it once a month at towards the end of the call, but if you want this recording, we'll make that available to you, okay? Just message me for it, okay, so that you can review it.
And Terry, she is on the Team Up, on the Team Up YouTube page. It's already there.
And did you know there was a Team Up YouTube page?
can we put it on the Team Up files for resources?
Sure.
On Facebook? I think that would be a very helpful place to have it.
It's also it'll be available on boards too.
Okay, so we'll have that. Thank you. Anybody else have any comments they want to make? Clarifying points? Okay, guys. There's a lot going on here tonight. Oh, go ahead. Patty.
Is it the same for Healthy Starts Family? Can you do that the same way?
Yes.
And order? Okay. That I had a little mix up with the other day, and I wasn't sure. I was trying to help Penny. So anyway. Okay. Good.
Thank you.
This is going to be very, very helpful. Thank you, Kathy.
Yeah, it really is going to be very helpful. Absolutely. And I'm going to review it several times. Okay. All right, guys. Thank you so much for participating tonight. Know you're appreciated. Know you're loved. We've got one more day to rock it for February business. And there is qualifiers day. Any order that you put in on Wednesday, you can roll it back into February business. And remember, what's our goal? Get qualified, stay qualified, okay? I would love to know how many of you now have received some leads or a lead in the month of February. Oh, John L., unmute yourself. What did you get, John L.?
I got a one-time order of the chocolate complete powder. And I reached out to the person and shared some recipe ideas. They did not respond, but that's okay.
And but you know what you need to do is share your story. Okay. Share your story with them and your experience. There you go. I'll take a chocolate complete order any day. Okay.
Me too.
All right. There we go. Doesn't it make us happy? We get an order. It's like all's right with the world. Okay. Hey guys. Good night. Good night. Have a great beginning of March, and we'll see you next Monday night.